interest is, destination, they have a dock, and port. They're here to golf, pretty much,
Yeah, we do all.
Do it, do it all.
We bring it in, and do the docking, east and west as well, and docking ponds. One pod will just bring it through the exit channels, get it to the inner water, then another pod will come on and just do the docking, so. We just don't do it, we do it all. Yes.
Who do you carry your insurance with, Boys of London, or?
On our license, we have a, actually, out of New York, and Los Angeles, San Francisco. We have a special insurance on our license, if we, are filed on, taken to court to pay for litigation, subsidized while we're in for litigation.
You have a question, Alan?
Yes, is the channel direction frequently, or yearly?
We have, depending on where it is.
Maintenance dredging, there are places that are so worse than others, but they have to go in and do maintenance dredging.
Are you kind of charged, you know?
Correction, it is.
They let you know?
Actually, we tell, we call and say, look, we're getting rid of the ship, it's trying to run on us, so we're feeling a little cushion as we're going through a certain part of the channel. You may want to come out.
Shall spot at the end of the journey.
And you may want to come out and do some, survey, and there'll be cross cuts, there were 100 or 50 to 25, whatever, to where they find it, I don't know. And then we'll, if it's, watch it, is it increasing something that we.
There's a dredge work in the bar channel right now, the dredge Columbia, looks like a little mini ship.
That's what you're seeing going on.
Yeah, y'all go out there and look, y'all see, I'm sure working. Just cleaning that, the entrance channel right now, they usually do it in the spring and again after hurricane season.
But we get about, actually, it's about every 3 years.
Every time we have a tropical storm, we'll go, have a problem showing after a tropical storm.
More for the Great Lakes, and the water level can be down, up, and so places shift, even though.
That's right.
And so the tonnage is different, they have to be half water, does that ever happen here?
Well, yeah, well, just as bad, if we get, we have a problem a lot of times, the reoccurring is, big number of 10, where the dog leg is on the north channel. It's 80, the work area deposits a lot of sand, and if it's gonna show, it'll start there first, so we'll, a lot of times, we'll watch it.
That first trick, our graph, negative 42, but that's.
So 45, restricted to 42, because we gotta get the, other carriers, get some permission. Because on a merchant ship, it's probably, on a Navy vessel, naval design ship, it does like a very, as you increase speed, it's quite about a stern, or about a. A merchant vessel is made of more cargo, and we don't share that, it squats by the head. Faster you go, the more the valve, so you figure your speed, you have a fuel plants, and you have your, draft, and whatever. A lot of companies have it on the house policy, whatever, it's, Coast Guard has that, which is.
These sand suckers or whatever, the dredges, where do they dump that spoilage?
They have, there's that area, just,
Around the west part of the water.
Out of the water, it's hopper dredge, like, nothing, the open strip, hopper dredge, it just drops.
Yes, sir.
Was there some cost? Deepening the channel, so I guess it's hard to ship in here?
Yes, there is, and we've done feasibility studies, yeah, myself.
In fact, the three of us ended up to,
The simulators, you know.
Corey there has been placed in Vicksburg, Mississippi, like, we've been up several times for the LNG study.
Right now, Houston is just about, we're in the process of going, matching us at 45, we were the deepest quarter. Be competitive, they've got the, they've already started their, Houston, they've been 45, we've got the permit, and it looks like those are going to start. And all, we're a little bit. It's 15 years.
Well, we're past 8 o'clock, this whole thing just fascinates me, I think probably is fascinating everybody else here. The one thing that these guys have not talked about is the absolute infinitesimal number of permutations of something to go wrong for the chat to think about. And there's no way that you can be, you can study and know this kind of stuff. If you can imagine, the higher the vessel rides in the water, because of the big sail, the lower it rides, the current is more effective against it. I also imagine that, and I'm just talking because I just assume that, there's some vessels that have a lot more reliability than others. And so you have to be concerned whether somebody's going to be up there ready to drop the anchor, just because you don't know what's going to happen. One of the things I didn't know, I was looking over the sheet as I went on the other day, and there's a line there on how many starts they can get. Depending on these big diesel engines, they have their air start. And if they have to stop the engine, you go to all stop and you just want to, just easing down there and don't have more power, and you have to start it up again, and then you have to do it again. There comes a point where there's no more air and you don't have any options. So there's so many things to think about that we ought to be real happy with these guys. Pay attention.
Yeah, they're just not being out of tune. I mean, it's, you're going out to catch you, the other way, you're in your outboard motor. There's a steel machine and everything. The rudder might, hydraulics and rudder might fail. We've got the engine might, low cylinder head or head gasket. I say it's all, but they usually have a backup system, to steering. Or actually, we have two pumps. But I mean, it's not uncommon. I've lost complete steering. We lost the main engine.
I had a 42-foot load out here inbound, and I just being going to sea, the ship vibrates. Anyway, the engine shut down. I said, "Captain, what's wrong with the engine?" "Oh, nothing."
I don't know what that was.